Hello, this is Sri from MCAL Global. We're going to talk about top 7 machine learning algorithms every beginner should know. Machine learning algorithms can be divided in 3 categories. Supervised learning, unsupervised learning, reinforcement learning. Supervised learning can be further subdivided in regression and classification. The top regression algorithms are linear regression, polynomial regression. The top classification algorithms are logistic regression, k nearest neighbor, decision trees. The popular unsupervised learning algorithms are k-means clustering, principal component analysis. Reinforcement learning is an advanced topic and it's not recommended at the beginner level. Before we get into the top 7 algorithms, let's look at supervised and unsupervised learning. Supervised learning. It is the task of inferring a function from the training data. The training data consists of a set of observations together with its outcome. It can be further subdivided in regression and classification algorithms. Regression is used to predict numerical values, and classification techniques are used to predict categorical values. Unsupervised learning. It is a set of algorithms used to draw inferences from data sets consisting of input data without using the outcome. The most common unsupervised learning method is cluster analysis, which is used for exploratory data analysis to find hidden patterns or groupings in data. Let us look into the top 7 algorithms that every beginner should know. Number 1, linear regression. It models relationship between observation and outcome using a straight line. Root mean square error and gradient descent is used to fit the best possible line. It provides insights into the factors that have greater influence on the outcome. Number 2, polynomial regression. It is a form of regression analysis in which the relationship between the observation and the outcome is modeled as an nth degree polynomial. The method is more reliable when the curve is built on large number of observations. Number 3, logistic regression. It is a misleading name. Even though the name suggests regression, but in reality, it is a classification technique. It is used to estimate the probability of a binary response. It can be generalized to predict more than 2 categorical values also. Number 4, k nearest neighbors. It is a classification technique where an object is classified by a majority vote of its neighbors. The observation is assigned to the class which is most common among its k nearest neighbors. The best choice of k depends upon the data. Generally, larger value of k reduce the effect of noise on the classification. Number 5, decision trees. It is a decision support tool that uses a tree-like model of decisions and their possible consequences. Decision trees aim to create a model that predicts by learning simple decision rules from the training data. Number 6, k-means clustering. K-means clustering aims to partition observations into k clusters. For instance, the items in a supermarket are clustered in categories, butter, cheese, and milk are grouped in dairy products. K means algorithm does not necessarily find the most optimal configuration. The K means algorithm is usually run multiple times to reduce this effect. Number 7, principal component analysis. It is a technique used to emphasize variation and bring out strong patterns in a data set. First principal component has the largest possible variance, that is, accounts for as much of the variability in the data as possible. Each succeeding component in turn has the highest variance possible under the constraint that it is orthogonal to the preceding components. This video was brought to you by MCAL Global, leaders in live online training, making complex topics easy. Visit our website at mcalglobal.com. Leave your comments below to get in touch with us, and don't forget to subscribe our channel to keep up to date with our latest and greatest.